November 4th, 2024. It's the day Airbus revealed the A321 MPA, at least as a concept and proposal. This unveiling took place in Paris at the Euronaval 2024 Defence Exhibition. Said to be based on the A321 XLR, the variant is designed to be a maritime patrol derivative that is arguably an answer to Boeing's P-8A Poseidon. In case you haven't figured it out yet, MPA stands for Maritime Patrol Aircraft. So, even though it's only been a few weeks, what do we know so far about this aircraft concept? How does it stack up to the Boeing P-8A Poseidon? Let's investigate for today's video. Like Boeing, Airbus has a proven track record of delivering military aircraft based on commercial platforms. Airbus has done this with the A330 MRTT based on the A330-200, as well as the A310 MRTT based on the A310. On the Boeing side, the 737 has been developed into a number of variants, including the E7 Wedgetail and P-8 Poseidon. The 767-200 is the foundation of the KC-46 tanker transport, while 747-200s have been modified to be E4 Night Watch and, of course, the current in-service Air Force Ones. Airbus commercial passenger narrowbodies have been modified for military use, although not specifically through Airbus itself. The German Air Force's A321 LRs underwent cabin modification by Lufthansa Technik to be suitable for both troop transport and medevac. So, when it comes to military derivatives based on commercial passenger platforms, the A321 MPA, and what it promises, is quite different from what is available on the market from Airbus today. An Airbus spokesperson shared the following statement with Simple Flying regarding the Airbus A321 MPA concept. The integration of a comprehensive mission system and a large weapons bay, while offering optimum performance at long range to perform high-end anti-submarine and anti-surface warfare missions from detection to engagement. Our platform also integrates a more comprehensive mission payload with latest generation sensors, such as the fixed antenna radar and a very advanced underwater detection solution, acoustic sensor, and sonar buoys. Essentially, the aircraft is meant to patrol the seas while also having the ability to hunt submarines and, if necessary, launch torpedoes. The A321 MPA will come with a magnetic anomaly detector in the tail, an addition which gives it the ability to detect submarines. Notably, most versions of the P-8 lack this feature, although the P-8I produced for the Indian Navy is equipped with a magnetic anomaly detector as per the customer's request. Naval News conducted an interview with Airbus Defence and Space's key account director Alexis Latty, who stated, "As one can see, this integration is with a commercial airframe in the Airbus A321 XLR, and a 40-year lifespan including easy upgradability and a focus on affordability." Thales is also a partner with Airbus on the A321 MPA project, as to avionics. The platform offers sufficient space and flexibility to accommodate future equipment, including equipment that may not exist today. The A321 MPA also features large observational windows, a forward-looking infrared or FLIR turret, as well as conformal radars, various antennas for communications and electronic surveillance, and a large weapons bay. Interestingly, in 2018, Airbus announced a similar yet never realized concept with the A320neo MPA. It's handy for the purposes of creating this video, since Airbus has yet to release such marketing material on the A321 MPA. When it comes to this newest potential offering, there will not be any wing pylons to externally mount anti-ship and surface strike weapons. This stands in contrast to the P-8A Poseidon, which you can see here loaded with AGM-84 harpoons for exercises. Naval News inquired about the lower rear fuselage of the A321 MPA, which is quite the departure from the round tube shape of its commercial equivalent. To this, the Airbus representative explained that this is the main structural modification of the aircraft. This larger, bulging weapons bay is designed to accommodate various ammunition completely inside the aircraft with no external mounts. This is Airbus's alternative to fitting additional armaments under the wings of the aircraft. Notably, the Boeing P-8 has an internal 5-station weapons bay in addition to its 4 wing pylons. The representative goes on to say that Airbus tried to limit the number of modifications in order to keep the price tag low. The Naval News interview ended with the representative explaining that not many more performance specifications could be disclosed due to a non-disclosure agreement with the French military. So, who is this aircraft for? Well, according to Aerospace Global News, the aircraft is part of Airbus's proposal to the French Navy to replace the Dassault Atlantique II. The A321 MPA concept was developed under an 18-month study contract awarded by the French government in early 2023, and Airbus received one of 2 contracts to conduct the study. The other contract was awarded to Dassault Aviation to study a maritime patrol aircraft / anti-submarine warfare derivative of its Falcon X business jet. And so, the jet will primarily be designed to suit the needs of the French Navy, but could be offered for export to other allied militaries around the world. So how does this aircraft compare with the P-8 Poseidon? Well, while the A321 MPA's role is the same, there are some notable differences. That's because the Poseidon is based on the 737-800 platform, a fuselage that is 15 feet or about 5 meters shorter than the length of the A321. Thus, in theory, the A321 MPA will have more cabin space for equipment and personnel compared to the Poseidon. Without performance specifications, it would be difficult to compare range and fuel efficiency of the jet. However, it's safe to assume that the A321 MPA will be more efficient thanks to newer generation engines, like the CFM LEAP, but possibly Pratt & Whitney geared turbofan engines. A very recent development to this video is that reports have surfaced that France has chosen Airbus's A321 MPA proposal over the Falcon 10X platform put forward by Dassault. Now, if Boeing were to have been in the running, we would imagine their argument would be that it's already available. Poseidons are more cost-effective and already have a proven track record of service with allied customers around the world. Indeed, when it comes to the Poseidon's size and capabilities, it seems to be the most popular choice among Western nations, being operated by the United States Navy, the Royal Australian Air Force, the UK's Royal Air Force, Norway's Royal Norwegian Air Force, and New Zealand's Royal New Zealand Air Force. The German Navy will take its first P-8 soon, and Canada placed an order in 2023. Thus, from an allied interoperability point of view, Boeing has an incredibly strong position in the market. From a cost and timeline perspective, these are good points in favour of choosing the already existing P-8. However, it's clear that France prefers to invest in its home industry and develop a more efficient alternative that is better prepared to adapt to future technologies. This could allow the A321 MPA to be a suitable contender against the Poseidon in the 2030s and beyond. But what do you think of Airbus's offering of the A321 MPA? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.